It's a tale we're all more than familiar with. Boy meets girl, girl falls for boy, and in 2 hours screen time, they're exchanging vows. These one-off tales of husband and wife both reflect and perpetuate the idyllic, constrictive conceptualization of American culture, one characterized by white picket fences and white-toothed grins as the groom pulls back the veil to kiss the bride. But this construction of Western culture is a harmful, exclusionary fallacy rooted entirely in the notion of compulsory heterosexuality.
Susan, I'm gay.
I'm gay.
I'm gay. I'm gay.
In her 1980 essay, Compulsory Heterosexuality and Lesbian Existence, Adrienne Rich discusses how heterosexuality has been coded as normative, expected culturally and socially, and how this enforcement of orientation directly affects the lesbian community. Even some of the most progressive among us will assume that an individual is straight until otherwise stated. We will assume their gender. We will assume their desire for marriage, for monogamy, for procreation. In accordance with our own perceptions and prejudices, the entertainment we produce and consume has followed this path of reinforcing heteronormativity. According to GLAAD, of the nearly 900 regular characters on primetime television this year, only 35, that's 4%, were identified as lesbian, gay, or bisexual. There were no trans characters in that count. And yes, some may argue that this is fiction, that made-up characters from the small and silver screen alike don't really have an impact in the grand scheme of things. But representation matters, as it grants three critical survival tools that prevent erasure of identity and promote the proclamation of selfhood, that is voice, visibility, and validation. It is an acknowledgement of presence, empowering and encouraging, and in an era of violence, it can be the difference between having yourself erased entirely and making yourself known. For queer women, faulty representation has hurt more than it has helped. Lesbians have long been either fetishized and objectified or stereotyped into butch femme binaries that reinforce heteronormative assumptions. Therefore, the need for accurate, positive representation, characters in lieu of caricatures, has never been more prevalent. In an era run by what we see on screen, the pushback against the notion of compulsory heterosexuality begins with demanding media that is not exhausted by the same black and white standards.